Requires elevation. What does that mean and what do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. While trying to install Office on my new computer, I received an error message stating requires elevation. What does that mean and how do I continue the Office install? Requires elevation is a symptom of Windows security, specifically the user account control feature. It prevents malware from doing things it shouldn't. What's it all about? First of all, elevation. It has nothing to do with your altitude. It has everything to do with your relative permission on the system. In other words, if you are a limited user account or you are not running as the administrator, you are considered to have a lower level of permissions than, say, an administrator account. Therefore, what's required is that your permissions be elevated to that of administrator. So, what does that mean? Well, in most cases, you're actually no longer going to see the message requires elevation. It still does show up from time to time in various places. But in reality, what you're seeing more often is the more traditional UAC prompt. Here's what I mean. I'm going to go ahead over here in Windows 11 and run Terminal in admin. That, by definition, requires elevation. You are running software and you want it to run as the administrator or with administrative privileges. The result? The UAC dialog, the one that we have seen over and over again in various places. That is the system saying what you are attempting to do requires elevation. That can happen as a side effect of running something as administrator, as we just did, or running something that may start up, but may then itself realize that it needs administrative privileges to do what it needs to do, so it'll pop up the UAC. Or in some cases, it'll just fail. And it may fail with an error message that says, requires elevation, and somehow you're supposed to know what to do. As an example, in my downloads folder here, I believe I have a copy of the Thunderbird setup. I'll just use that as my example. In your case, the Outlook setup program may fall into the same category, whatever it is you've downloaded and are attempting to set up. I have no idea whether Thunderbird requires elevation. I don't think it does. But let's say that it did. And it errored out and said requires elevation. What do I do to actually run the program successfully? Well, you right-click on it and run as administrator. What this will do is it will do exactly what we just did with Terminal. It will basically, before this program even runs, it will be set up with administrative privileges. That way, the program, when it checks, do I have the privilege I need to accomplish this task, it'll say yes and proceed appropriately. So in cases where the program doesn't know to ask and only fails because it does not have administrative privileges, run as administrator is your friend. That's the right solution in almost all cases. Now, there is another solution that I suggest you not do. I'm going to go ahead and once again run Terminal as administrator. But this time I'm going to show more details. This can be interesting just in and of itself. It shows you exactly what program is running, what program is requesting the administrative privileges that you are being asked about. But change when these notifications appear basically allows you to control how user account control is implemented on your system. Notify me only when apps try to make changes to my computer. This is the default. This is what you probably have set on your own machine. And this is one of those situations where this is honestly the right setting. However, you can go lower and lower and indeed never notify me. Basically, apps that require administrative privileges, apps that ask for administrative privileges are just going to get administrative privileges, whether you want them to or not. You won't see a UAC dialog. You won't see requires elevation because it'll just happen magically. This is a very bad setting to leave this way. My strong recommendation is that you basically don't screw with it, that you leave it exactly where it was to begin with. It's exactly where I'm going to leave it. Here's why. The issue is, very simply, malware. As an individual user, as a home user, if you accidentally download and run malware, user account control prevents that malware from doing things that it shouldn't be doing without notifying you first that it's trying to do something. If you run a download, if you accidentally run something and it asks you for UAC, for administrative privileges, stop, think, make sure it's what you think it is. Make sure it is something that you actually asked for, and make sure that it is something that legitimately needs administrative access. Office? Sure, I can understand that. There's so many other things you could be downloading that have no reason asking for administrative access. If they do, it might be because they either are malware or they are in the process of delivering malware that does want administrative access so that it can insert itself into places that it shouldn't. The other scenario, and this is actually less common for home users and even business users, small business users, is the corporate environment. UAC basically prevents people from installing things that the company doesn't want them to install. Normally, if you've got an administrator-capable account, the UAC prompt will be as we saw. It'll just be an okay or no kind of situation because the account that I'm signed into has administrator capability. It's just not enabled until I say yes. However, in the corporate environment, you may be running with what's called a limited user account. That's an account that does not have administrative privileges. The only difference is that when you see the UAC prompt, you will be required to enter an administrator password. Your ability to do that means that, yeah, you are legit, you have the right to do whatever this is. In a corporate environment, chances are they're not going to give you the password because they don't want you installing random things on your machine. They want more control over the machines that are being deployed in the corporation. But that's what it boils down to. It is one of those things where it's a very simple concept. It's actually very safe. It's very common. It's also a situation that you will also find on Macs and on Linux machines. It's very common to have to go through something very similar on those. My recommendation, leave UAC on, and whenever you get asked about requiring elevation or administrative privileges, just do a double take. Make sure it is legit and something that you want. And if you're not sure, don't. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3274. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.